Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College. I am happy to meet you again on the video lecture in the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. We are discussing on the steam power cycle, and this is lecture number 4 on the steam power cycle. So we recap from the previous cycle, previous lecture. So in the previous lecture, we studied about the reheat Rankine cycle and we solved a few problems on the reheat Rankine cycle. So we continue with the problems here on the reheat Rankine cycle. The topic for the lecture is problems in the reheat Rankine cycle, the learning outcome to the students. So at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the reheat Rankine cycle. So we continue with the previous problems. This is also from the Anna University question paper, May 2019, example number 8. The steam condition at inlet to a turbine are 42 bar and 500 degree Celsius, and the condenser pressure is 0.035 bar. Assume that the steam is just dry saturated on leaving the first turbine and it is reheated to its initial temperature. Calculate the Rankine cycle efficiency, specific steam consumption with the reheating by neglecting the pump work using Mollier chart. So the earlier problems we solved with the help of a steam table. Now it is specifically given you have to use the Mollier chart. So the Mollier chart is graphical representation of all the steam properties. So along with your steam table, there is a big chart available with the x-axis specific entropy and the y-axis specific enthalpy, and using the chart we will solve the problem. First write down the given data. So the initial pressure is 42 bar and the temperature T1 equal to T3 equal to 500 degree Celsius, and the condenser pressure P4 equal to P5 equal to 0.035 bar. The steam is dry saturated on leaving the high pressure turbine. And this is what the enthalpy entropy diagram, that is Mollier chart. So the graphical representation. So how to use the chart for locating various points? And if you spread your Mollier chart, you may find a dark line here. So that line, red color line what I have drawn here. So you may find a dark line with a black color, that is called a saturation line. So below the saturation line, we have the wet steam. So the property here below the saturation line, we have the wet steam. Above the saturation line, we have the superheated steam. On the saturation line, the properties of dry saturated steam. So on the saturation line, dry saturated steam. Above the saturation line, superheated steam. And below the saturation line, we have the wet steam. So this entropy in the x-axis and the specific enthalpy in the y-axis, and we have other lines. So the constant pressure line running throughout the diagram for various pressure. So all the pressures whatever available in the steam table, everything will be available here. And below the saturation line, we may have constant constant dryness fraction line, and above the saturation line, we may find the temperature line, constant temperature line. Now we have to find out the properties. We want to calculate the enthalpy, only locate the point and find the enthalpy from the Mollier chart. First, pressure inlet of the turbine, inlet of the high pressure turbine. The pressure is P1 equal to 42 bar and T1 equal to 500 degree Celsius. So you locate the pressure line at the 42 bar and the temperature line at the 500 degree Celsius. So the pressure line, temperature line will intersect at a point. Locate the point, this is 1. Now, corresponding to the 1, you take the enthalpy, which is 3450 kilojoules per kilogram. So, draw the horizontal line, you can read the enthalpy here. Now, for expansion of the high pressure turbine, so 1 to 2, so you draw one vertical line. This is reversible isentropic, reversible adiabatic or isentropic expansion, so the entropy is constant. For constant entropy, you draw one vertical line, and the condition here, the steam is dry saturated on leaving the HP turbine. So draw the vertical line and stop here on the saturated line. So this is point number 2. Then here you find the enthalpy, that is H2, which is 2720 kilojoules per kilogram. And you can note down the pressure here. So along the pressure line you move. So there will be a pressure line. So along the pressure line you move here. And again this pressure line is intersecting at the 500 degrees Celsius. So look at the point 3. So this is the 3. So for 3 you find the enthalpy, so which is 3490 kilojoules per kilogram. Then from 3 again the expansion in the low pressure turbine. So draw one vertical line. So to meet at the pressure P4 equal to 0.035 bar. So below the saturation, it will be meeting below the saturation line. So here you look at the point 4. So H4 equal to 2540 kilojoules per kilogram. So 1 to 2 expansion in the high pressure turbine, 2 to 3 heating in the reheater, and 3 to 4 the expansion in the low pressure turbine. So using the Mollier chart, you can take the properties in all the 4 enthalpies from the diagram. Then you refer to the steam table at the P4 equal to 0.035 bar. So HFI equal to 111.8 kilojoules per kilogram. So this is the another enthalpy required for our calculation. So H1, H2, H3, H4 and H5. So turbine work. So WT equal to H1 minus H2 plus H3 minus H4. So substituting 3450 minus 2720 plus 3490 minus 2540 equal to 1680 kilojoules per kilogram. So the heat supplied QS equal to H1 minus H6 plus H3 minus H2. So this equal to 3450 minus 111.8 plus 3490 minus 2720 equal to 4108.2 kilojoules per kilogram. So the thermal efficiency eta equal to WT minus WP divided by heat supplied. So the pump work is neglected here. So in the example, in the problem, definition statement of the problem, it is given that the pump work is neglected. So we assume WP equal to 0. So 1680 divided by 4108.2 equal to 0.409, which is 40.9%. That is the efficiency of the reheat Rankine cycle. And the specific steam consumption of the steam rate, SR equal to 3600 divided by WT minus WP equal to 3600 divided by 1680 minus 0 equal to 2.14 kilograms per kilowatt hour. So this is the steam rate or the specific steam consumption. So the answer to the problem, specific steam consumption is 2.14 kilogram per kilowatt hour and thermal efficiency is 40.9%. We take next example. So this is from the May 2015 question paper. A steam power plant operates on theoretical reheat cycle. The steam is at 25 bar and 400 degrees Celsius is supplied to a high pressure turbine. After its expansion to a dry state, the steam is reheated at constant pressure to its original temperature. The subsequent expansion occurs in the LP turbine to a condenser pressure of 0.04 bar. Considering feed pump work, make calculation to determine quality of the steam at the entry of the condenser, thermal efficiency, specific steam consumption. So this is from May 2015 question paper. So you write down the given data. So initial pressure P1 equal to 25 bar, P4 condenser pressure equal to 0.04 bar, and T1 temperature at the entry of the HP turbine and after reheating it is 400 degrees Celsius. The condition is the steam is dry saturated on leaving the HP turbine. Now we refer to the steam table like here. So using the steam table, P1 equal to 25 bar and T1 equal to 400 degrees Celsius for superheated steam, we take the enthalpy H1 equal to 3240.65 kilojoules per kilogram and S1 entropy equal to 7.018 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So this is the initial enthalpy and the entropy. So for the expansion of the HP turbine, the condition is S1 equal to S2. The entropy is constant. And another condition given here, the steam is dry saturated on leaving the HP turbine. We have two conditions. One is entropy S1 equal to S2 equal to 7.018 and the condition is dry saturated steam. Now you refer to the steam table. In the table number 2, the last column, last column you may find the pressure, and before that you may find the value entropy SG value. And move vertically in the steam table, you locate the point where SG2 equal to 7.018, because S1 equal to S2 equal to 7, SG2 equal to 7.018. So you may find a value right between the two pressures 2.7 and 2.8 bar. So the pressure P2, that is after expansion, the pressure P2 equal to P3 equal to 2.75 bar. So you have to carefully use the steam table. So you have right now you have 7.018 SG value available for the pressure of 2.75 bar. So you have to go for interpolation between two values 2.7 and 2.8. Now from the steam table at the pressure P2 equal to 2.75 bar, H2 equal to HG2 equal to 2720.7 kilojoules per kilogram. So this is also again you have to use the interpolation technique. Now from the steam table at the pressure P3 equal to 2.75 bar and T3 equal to 400 degrees Celsius for superheated steam, H3 equal to 3275.55 kilojoules per kilogram, S3 equal to 8.0765 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And from the condenser pressure, P4 equal to 0.04 bar, HF4 equal to 121.4 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG4 equal to 2433.1 kilojoules per kilogram, VF4 equal to 0.001004 meter cube per kilogram, SF4 equal to 0.423 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SFG4 equal to 8.053 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now for the isentropy expansion LP turbine, S3 equal to S4. So S3 value we have taken from the steam table, S3 equal to 8.0765. So S3 equal to, finally it is with steam, so SF4 plus X4 into SFG4. So substituting the numerical values, 8.0765 equal to 0.423 plus X4 into 8.053. So solving this equation, X2 equal to 0.95, and we calculate the enthalpy H4 equal to HF4 plus X4 into HFG4, which is 121.4 plus 0.95 into 2433.1, which is equal to 2432.8 kilojoules per kilogram, and the enthalpy H5 equal to HF5, which is 121.4 kilojoules per kilogram. So we calculated H1, H2, we calculated here, look at the first page, H1, H2 and H3, here we have calculated H4 and H5. To calculate the H6 value, we refer the pump work. So for the specific enthalpy in the pump, WP equal to H6 minus H5, which is equal to VF5 into P6 minus P5. So VF5 equal to 0.001004 into P6 equal to P1 equal to 25 bar minus 0.04 equal into 100 to convert pressure bar into kilopascal. So calculating, it is 2.5 kilojoules per kilogram. So the pump work is 2.5 kilojoules per kilogram. And from this equation, H6 equal to 2.5 plus 121.4 equal to 123.9 kilojoules per kilogram. Now we have all the enthalpies. Now we calculate the turbine work. So turbine work equal to H1 minus H2 plus H3 minus H4. So WT equal to 3240.65 minus 2720.7 plus 3275.55 minus 2431.22 equal to 1362.7 kilojoules per kilogram. And the heat supplied equal to QS equal to H1 minus H6 plus H3 minus H2. So equal to 3240.65 minus 123.9 plus 3275.55 minus 2720.7 equal to 3671.6 kilojoules per kilogram. And the thermal efficiency, eta equal to WT minus WP divided by QS, which is 1362.7 minus WP, pump work is equal to 2.5 kilojoules, 2.5 divided by 3671.6 equal to 0.37, which is 37%. So the thermal efficiency of the reheat cycle equal to 37%, and the specific steam consumption or steam rate, which is SR equal to 3600 divided by WT minus WP, which is equal to 3600 divided by 1362.7 minus 2.5 equal to 2.64 kilogram per kilowatt hour. So this is the steam rate and this is the efficiency. And answer to the problem, the specific steam consumption is 2.64 kg per kilowatt hour and the thermal efficiency of the cycle is 37%. We take example number 10 from the university question paper, May 2017 and November 2019. A reheat cycle receives steam at 35 bar and 0.1 bar. Steam enters the first stage steam turbine at 350 degrees Celsius. If reheating is done at 8 bar to 350 degrees Celsius, calculate specific steam consumption and reheat Rankine cycle efficiency. So you write down the given data. So P1 equal to P6 equal to 35 bar, P2 equal to P3 equal to 8 bar, reheat pressure is 8 bar, P4 equal to P5 equal to 0.1 bar, that is condenser pressure is 0.1 bar, temperature T1 equal to T3 equal to 350 degree Celsius, and this is the simple TS diagram for the process reheat cycle. So from the steam table, P1 equal to 35 bar, T1 equal to 350 degree Celsius for superheated steam. So H1 equal to 3106.45 kilojoules per kilogram, S1 equal to 6.663 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And from the steam table, P2 equal to 8 bar, S1 equal to S2 equal to S0 equal to 6.66. So we find the steam is dry saturated at the outlet of the HP turbine. So H2 equal to HG2 equal to 2767.4 kilojoules per kilogram. So fortunately, the steam is the enthalpy, the specific entropy only 6.6. So here it is 6.663 here. So these two are equal. So the enthalpy is directly we take for the dry saturated steam from the steam table. And from the steam table again, P3 equal to 8 bar and T3 equal to 350 degrees Celsius for superheated steam. H3 equal to 3162.4 kilojoules per kilogram and S3 equal to 7.411 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And again from the steam table, P4 equal to 0.1 bar condenser pressure, HF4 equal to 191.8 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG4 equal to 2392.9 kilojoules per kilogram, VF4 specific volume, VF4 equal to 0.00101 metric cube per kilogram, SF4 equal to 0.649 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SFG4 equal to 7.502 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. All these values you have to carefully note down from the steam table. And for LP turbine, isentropic expansion in the LP turbine, we have S3 equal to S4. So S3 value already we have 7.411 and S4 equal to SF4 plus X4 into SFG4. Substitute in numerical values, 7.411 equal to 0.649 plus X4 into 7.502. So that gives X2 equal to 0.9. Then we calculate H4 equal to HF4 plus X4 into HFG4. Which is 191.8 plus 0.9 plus 2392. So this value 2392.9 equal to 2345.41 kilojoules per kilogram. So using the calculator, you calculate and H5 equal to HF5 equal to 191.8. So the pressure P4 equal to P5. So H4 equal to F4 equal to HF5. 191.8 kilojoules per kilogram. Then the specific enthalpy in the pump, WP equal to H6 minus H5, which is VFI into P6 minus P5, so 0.00101 into 35 minus 0.1 into 100. So this 100 to convert the bar into kilopascal, so the pump work is 3.5 kilojoules per kilogram and the H6, so H6 minus H5 equal to 3.5, so H6 equal to 3.5 plus 191.8 equal to 195.3 kilojoules per kilogram. So, in all the values, H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6, all the enthalpies were calculated. Now, we go for the calculation. Turbine work. So, turbine work equal to H1 minus H2 plus H3 minus H4. So, which is 3106.45 minus 2767.4 plus 3162.4 minus 2345.41. That gives 1156.04 kilojoules per kilogram. And heat supplied QS equal to H1 minus H6 plus H3 minus H2. So QS equal to 3106.45 minus 195.3 plus 3162.4 minus 2767.4 equal to 3305.15 kilojoules per kilogram. then the thermal efficiency eta equal to WT minus WP divided by heat supplied, which is 1156.04 minus pump work is 3.5 we calculated earlier, and this is 3306.15. So calculating, the efficiency is 0.348 or 34.8%, and the specific steam consumption, so SR equal to 3600 divided by net work output, which is WT minus WP, which is equal to 3600 divided by 1156.04 minus 3.5 equal to 3.12 kilograms per kilowatt hour. Then the answer to the problem, the specific steam consumption is 3.12 kilograms per kilowatt hour and thermal efficiency is 34.8%. And we take example number 11 from the analysis question paper, May 2017. A steam at 30 bar and 400 degrees Celsius is allowed to expand isentropically in a steam turbine to a pressure of 0.08 bar. Determine the drainage fraction of the steam at the end of the cycle and thermal efficiency of the cycle. Then the second part, you have another part of the problem. Now, if the same steam is allowed to expand isentropically to a pressure of 3 bar, and reheated to 380 degrees Celsius and then allowed to expand again in the turbine to a final pressure of 0.08 bar. Determine the drainage fraction of the steam at the end of the expansion and thermal efficiency of the cycle. So, the first part is ordinary, a simple Rankine cycle, and the second part is reheat cycle. Then we have to solve two problems here. So, the given data, simple Rankine cycle. So, first part. So, P1 equal to P4 equal to 30 bar. T1 equal to 400 degrees Celsius, P2 equal to P3 equal to 0.08 bar. So, for the first initial condition, from the steam table, P1 equal to 30 bar and T1 equal to 400 degrees Celsius. So, for superheated steam, H1 equal to 3232.5 kilojoules per kilogram and S1 equal to 6.925 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And from the condenser, for the condenser pressure, from the steam table again, P2 equal to 0.08 bar. You take HF2 equal to 173.9 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG2 equal to 2403.2 kilojoules per kilogram, VF2 equal to 0.001008 meter cube per kilogram, SF2 equal to 0.593 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SFG2 equal to 7.637 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So, all the values from the steam table corresponding to the pressure 0.08 bar. Then for isentropic expansion, S1 equal to S2, so S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2, so 6.925 equal to 0.593 plus X2 into 7.637, so solving this equation, X2 equal to 0.83, then we calculate H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, which is 173.9 plus 0.83 into 2403.2, which is equal to 2168.5 kilojoules per kilogram. Then the turbine work WT equal to H1 minus H2, which is 3232.5 minus 2168.5 equal to 1064 kilojoules per kilogram. Pump work, so WP equal to H4 minus H3, which is VF3 into P4 minus P3 into 100. So H4 minus H3 equal to 0.001008 into 30 minus 0.08 into 100. That is equal to 3 kilojoules per kilogram, and H4 equal to 3 plus 173.9 equal to 176.9 kilojoules per kilogram, and the heat supplied QS equal to H1 minus H4, which is 3232.5 minus 176.9 equal to 3055.6 kilojoules per kilogram. We have calculated all the parameter. We calculate thermal efficiency, eta equal to WT minus WP divided by QS. So, 1064 minus 3 divided by 3055.6 equal to 0.347. So, the efficiency is 34.7%. Now, we take the first for simple Rankine cycle. Now, we take the reheat cycle. Using the same data, we solve the problem for reheat cycle. So, initial pressure P1 equal to P6 equal to 30 bar, T3 equal to 380 degrees Celsius, P2 equal to P3 equal to 3 bar and P4 equal to P5 equal to 0.08 bar. So, there is no change in the H1 value. Now, H1 value is as it is. Now, H2 value we have to calculate. From 0.2 we have to calculate. So, from the steam table, P2 equal to 3 bar, TS2 equal to 133.5 degrees Celsius, HFT equal to 561.5 kJ per kilogram, HFGT equal to 2163.2 kJ per kilogram Kelvin, SFT equal to 1.672 kJ per kilogram Kelvin, SFGT equal to 5.319 kJ per kilogram Kelvin. Now we assume the expansion in the HP turbine is for isentropic expansion in the HP turbine, S1 equal to S2. So S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So S1 already we have taken, it is 6.925 equal to 1.672 plus X2 into 5.319. So solving this equation, X2 equal to 0.98. So H2 we calculate HF2 plus X2 into HFG2. So which is 561.5 plus 0.98 into 2163.2 equal to 2681.4 kilojoules per kilogram. And from the steam table, for the third condition, third point, entry of the LP turbine, so P3 equal to 3 bar, T3 equal to 380 degree Celsius for superheated steam, H3 equal to 3233.88 kilojoules per kilogram, and S3 equal to 7.97 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And this is the TS diagram. Now from the P4, the condenser pressure, P4 equal to 0.08 bar, HF4 equal to 173.9 kilojoules per kilogram. HFG4 equal to 2403.2 kilojoules per kilogram. VF4 equal to 0.001008 meter cube per kilogram. SF4 equal to 0.593 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And SFG4 equal to 7.637 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now for the expansion in the LP turbine, so S3 equal to S4. So, S3 equal to SF4 plus X4 into SFG4, substituting numerical values, 7.97 equal to 0.593 plus X4 into 7.637. So, you calculate the value, solve the equation, calculate the value, X4 equal to 0.96. Then, H4 equal to HF4 plus X4 into HFG4, which is 173.9 plus 0.96 into 2403.2 equal to 2480.97 kilojoules per kilogram, and H5 equal to HF5, so H5 equal to HF5 which is equal to HF4 which is 173.9 kilojoules per kilogram. Then for the pump, specific enthalpy in the pump, WP equal to H6 minus H5 which is VF5 into P6 minus P5, multi substituting numerical value is 0.001008 into 30 minus P1, P6 equal to P1 30 bar, P5 equal to P4 0.08 bar, so 30 minus 0.08 into 100, so this equal to, the pump work is equal to 3 kilograms per kilojoules per kilogram, and H6 equal to H5 plus pump work, so 3 plus 173.9 equal to 176.9 kilojoules per kilogram. Then calculate the turbine work, equal to H1 minus H2 plus H3 minus H4, so substituting numerical values, 3232.5 minus 2681.4 plus 3233.88 minus 2480.97 equal to 1304 kilojoules per kilogram, and the heat supplied QS equal to H1 minus H6 plus H3 minus H2. So substituting numerical values, 3232.5 minus 176.9 plus 3233.88 minus 2681.4 equal to 3608.08 kilojoules per kilogram. So thermal efficiency equal to WT minus WP divided by heat supplied. So 1304 minus 3 divided by 3608.08 equal to 0.36. So 36%. The answer to the problem, for a simple Rankine cycle, dryness fraction at the end of expansion X2 equal to 0.83. Thermal efficiency is 34.7. And reheat cycle, dryness fraction at the end of expansion X4 equal to 0.96 and thermal efficiency is 36%. So we observe the thermal efficiency of the reheat cycle is increasing and the dryness fraction quality of the steam is also increasing. These are all the advantages of the reheat cycle. The thermal efficiency increases and the quality of the steam at the exhaust is also increasing. And we take the example number 12. From the question paper, May 2016, a steam at 90 bar and 480 degree Celsius is supplied to a steam turbine. The steam is reheated to its original temperature by passing the steam through a reheater at 12 bar. The expansion after reheating takes place to a condenser pressure of 0.07 bar. Find the efficiency of the reheat cycle. Work output if the flow of the steam is 5 kilograms per second. Neglect the pressure loss in the system. Assume expansion to the turbine and the pump are isentropic. Do not neglect the pump work. So, you have to consider the pump work. So, this is from the May 2016 question paper. So, it is another problem with repeated number of calculations. So, without any tiredness, we solve the problem. Or you listen to the video, then you take the problem and solve your own so that you will get the confidence. We are given P1 equal to P6 initial pressure is 90 bar and T1 equal to T3 equal to 480 degree Celsius. P2 equal to P3 reheat pressure is 12 bar and the condenser pressure is P4 equal to P5 equal to 0.07 bar and the mass flow rate is 5 kilograms per second. So, we take one by one property from the steam table for the initial condition. Pressure P1 equal to 90 bar, T1 equal to 480 degree Celsius for superheated steam, H1 equal to 3280.56 kilojoules per kilogram and entropy equal to S1 equal to 6.5128 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And from the steam table for reheat pressure P2 equal to 12 bar, S1 equal to SG2 equal to 6.519 which is equal to 6.5128. So, the steam is dry saturated at the end of the HP turbine. Then H2 equal to HG2 equal to 2782.7 kilojoules per kilogram. So, when you refer to the steam table at the pressure P2 equal to 12 bar, SG2 equal to 6.519 whereas S1 equal to 6.5128. So, these two are equal, approximately equal. So, we can conclude that the steam is dry saturated steam at the end of the HP turbine and you can take H2 equal to HG2 equal to 2782.7 kilojoules per kilogram. And this is what our diagram. So, it is a representative diagram not for the exact values. So, from the steam table P3 equal to 12 bar and T3 equal to 480 degree Celsius for superheated steam, H3 equal to 3390.18 kilojoules per kilogram and S3 equal to 7.5578 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And again for the pressure condenser pressure P4 equal to 0.07 bar, HF4 equal to 163.4 kilojoules per kilogram. HFG4 equal to 2409.2 kilojoules per kilogram, VF4 equal to 0.001007 meter cube per kilogram, SF4 equal to 0.559 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and SFG4 equal to 7.716 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now, the expansion the LP turbine, we have S3 equal to S4, so S3 equal to S4, so S3 equal to SF4 plus X4 into SFG4. So, 7.5578 equal to 0.559 plus X4 into 7.716. So, solving this equation, you will get X4 equal to 0.9. Then, H4 equal to HF4 plus X4 into HFG4. So, substituting the numerical values, 163.4 plus 0.9 into 2409.2 equal to 2331.68 kilojoules per kilogram. H5 equal to HFI. So, the 0.5 is the saturated liquid. So, HFI equal to 163.4 kilojoules per Kelvin, kilojoules per kilogram. So, the turbine work equal to WT equal to H1 minus H2 plus H3 minus H4. So, substituting WT equal to 3280.56 minus 2782.7 plus 3390.18 minus 2331.68. So, the turbine work equal to 1556.36 kilojoules per kilogram. Then the specific enthalpy of the pump. So, WP equal to H6 minus H5 which is equal to VFI into P6 minus P5 which is 0.001007 into 90 minus 0.07 into 100 equal to 9 kilojoules per kilogram. H6 equal to 9 plus H5. So, 9 plus 163.4 equal to 172.4 kilojoules per kilogram. Then we calculate the heat supplied. Which is H1 minus H6 plus H3 minus H2. So, substituting numericals 3280.56 minus 172.4 plus 3390.18 minus 2782.7 equal to 3715.64 kilojoules per kilogram. then we calculate the net power output P equal to power equal to M into WT minus WP, which is 5 into 1556.36 minus 9 equal to 7736.8 kilowatts. Thermal efficiency equal to eta equal to WT minus WP divided by heat supplied, which is 1556.36 minus 9 divided by 3715.64 equal to 0.416, which is 41.6%. So the answer to the problem, power output equal to 7736.8 kilowatts and thermal efficiency is 41.6%. So we stop here. So these are all the reference books I used for preparing the slides. So you can also refer to it for additional information on the problem. You can write to my mail ID for queries or clarification. I will sincerely answer. So thank you very much for your patient hearing. We'll meet again.